Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're new, thank you for joining. Today's video is gonna be a new kind of video that I haven't done yet, but it's actually requested from you guys. So I love interior design, I love decorating. I am by no means a professional, but I do consider it just a passion and a hobby of mine, and you guys seem to enjoy our home and our decor and everything. So I'm starting this series where I'll be doing little sit-down chat sessions where I explain sort of the design process and the inspo and everything behind areas in our house. So today's episode, I guess I'll call this episodes. Today's video is going to be about our entryway and our living room. And if you don't know, we currently live in an industrial style loft. So it's basically just one big room that makes these areas a little bit harder to identify, but just keep that in mind that it's a little non-traditional. If you want to see something that's less in-depth or anything else, I also have other videos on my channel that are just like a walkthrough home tour. One is pretty much like a silent walkthrough home tour. I have a blog post, so you can find all the inspo everywhere. But I'm really excited to dive a little bit deeper today and share how I have pieced these rooms together with you guys. So the first room that I'm gonna be explaining to you guys is our entryway. So some homes don't have an entryway and they all probably look a little bit different. Ours is basically just a hallway. So it's nothing like too exciting, and we basically could have left it untouched probably and it wouldn't have been that big of a deal because we don't spend that much time in that area of the house. But it is a really pretty hallway because it has a lot of windows in it and natural light. And as I mentioned before, we really enjoy decorating. So we decided to take that as an opportunity to design some things. So I will say that something that I feel is important with an entryway is it is the first thing you see when you walk into your house. For the most part, I feel like it helps if you make that pretty, and that's kind of where we went with ours. One of the things that I feel is really useful in an entryway is finding ways for storage and just practical things like that. So in our entryway, we have a coat rack hook system where you can put bags, sweatshirts, jackets, anything like that. You can make it somewhat aesthetically pleasing with design. Ours is nothing crazy. I actually got it at TJ Maxx. I've never found one that I was obsessed with. I feel like it's not that important to have it be the cutest thing in your house since you're just gonna end up putting coats and things on it anyways, but just something that kind of matches your aesthetic and then pop it in a corner, like right behind the door. And I feel like it's such a good way to get some use out of your entryway. We also don't have any of this in this current house, but before we've put like cute aesthetic baskets in the hallway for shoes and stuff, which is a nice storage system and it's a cute design as well. And then for our entryway, since it is just kind of like a long hallway and we do live in an industrial style building, the floors are concrete. So to brighten it up and to also warm it up and make it a little bit homier, we decided to put a runner in that space, which is a really nice place for a rug if you do have sort of like a long hallway entryway style setup. I got one that's kind of multicolored. It's from Urban Outfitters. And I like it to have like texture and color and everything to sort of tie in the rest of the house. I don't like a super plain rug in the entryway. And then something else that I feel is so nice in an entryway is a decorative little bench. Our entryway wasn't quite big enough for a nice table system. I can share some pictures from like Pinterest or something of what I'm talking about, where there's like a nice entryway table with like a bowl and plants and books and everything where you put your keys and all that stuff. We didn't really have space for that, so we opted for a bench instead. And we actually picked up this bench from Target. I think it's so cute. I love that the legs are a little more intricate and they're not just like boring, smooth wood. They're kind of like carved out, which I think is really pretty, and it gives it like an antique vibe almost, which is something that we kind of tied throughout this entire house. Just because it is like industrial and masculine and kind of like cool toned and everything, we tried to warm it up with like a antique vibe everywhere. So I love that bench for that. The top of it, the cushion is gray, which I would love something a little bit warmer since the rest of the house is so cool toned, but it honestly works and it's nice. You can like take your shoes off there. You can also pile a bunch of things up there, which is not aesthetic at all, but it happens all the time. So I mean, I might as well share that with you guys. And then similar to like a little table setup in your entryway, whether it's a bench or a table, I think it's really nice to put put like a statement piece of art right above that. So like a bold, beautiful piece of art. And I have this print from Urban Outfitters that I love. And you guys always ask me about it on Instagram. So I know you love it too. It's actually a black canvas, which I think is really cool. It's very bold. And then it's just like a simple female form line drawing. And it's done in a white line, which I think is so pretty. And then to sort of like warm that up and make it a little more antique feeling as well, we put that in a gold frame. I believe we got that off of Amazon. And together it just ties in really nicely with the bench. I feel like they're both like beautiful, sort of intricate looking pieces, and they make a nice statement in the entryway. And then another thing that kind of just like adds to that and can be put in any entryway is like a plant or a fake plant. So we have some pampas grass and we just put those in like a tall vase that we got from TJ Maxx, I believe. And I love that it adds just like a little bit of texture and life and just like a really nice aesthetic touch to the hallway. So put pampas grass anywhere and it's gonna do something good for the space. And I love the way it looks in an entryway. All right, and then moving on to the living room from the entryway, which is behind me right now, we have this space that's kind of in between the two, and we decided to call it living room for the purpose of this video because I think these items would work best in most people's living room rather than their entryway. But just to give you guys some backstory, it is kind of like an in between the two for us in this space. So basically this mirror that is in this space is probably one of the best investments I've ever made. It is quite expensive. It's from Anthropologie. I feel like it's a famous internet mirror. So many people have it and it's beautiful in every single space. And this one that we have over in this part of the house is the 5-foot mirror. We also have the 7-foot mirror over in a different part of the house, which I'll get to in a different video. But I love this mirror. We decided to turn it into like a little fireplace vibe. So I got a bunch of candle stands and I actually just picked these up from TJ Maxx and Ross. So they were super inexpensive and I mixed metal and wood because I really like mixing textures and materials like that. And then I just got a bunch of different heights and everything and basically created a little cluster so that it kind of creates like a romantic vibey fireplace feel. And it looks super good with the intricacy of the mirror and it kind of makes it all feel very vintage and chic. And I just love it. It's super fun since it is like spring right now. We don't really have it set up as a fireplace, but in fall and winter, especially around the holidays, I put it all right in front of the mirror and kind of like a loose V formation. And it really looks a lot more like a fireplace vibe then. And it's so pretty and you light the candles and the flames reflect in the mirror, which just creates like an entire mood and everything. And it's so pretty. Obviously you have to be really careful and responsible with your candles in that situation because it's not a real fireplace, but it is a really pretty aesthetic trick and it looks good when the candles are not lit as well. And then something else that's really nice for any space, I feel like it's probably the thing that helps the most with any room, is to just add plants. And if real plants are just like a no for you, that's fine. They have some really beautiful, great fake plants that will never die on you. And they might be a little expensive, but at least you don't have to keep buying plants that die. So our plants are all real at this time. Some of them are giving me, you know, hell, and I might have to get a fake plant eventually. But for now, they're all real. And we just have two trees in this space to kind of offset each other and make it really almost jungly, which I love that vibe. And then we just have a smaller snake plant below that. And I just love the pop of green and the life and the different texture and element that it adds. And then we also put some picture frames with pictures of, those are actually prints that of pictures that we've taken. And we just decorated those, or we just utilized those on the floor instead of hanging them. We don't have a ton of wall space in this place. And I actually love the way pictures look on the floor. We just kind of like stacked those up next to each other and it just really filled out this area and I think it turned out so nicely. And then moving on to the more traditional living room section, I would say, because this part of our house is actually the most room in the house, I think, since it's kind of like a square cutout for it. So I feel like with a living room, it is worth it to get the biggest couch that fits well in the space and is comfy, because if you're like us, you probably spend a lot of time in there. And the time that we do spend in our living room is like watching movies, shows, hanging out with our friends, playing board games and stuff. And it's really nice to have a couch that suits the space. It can fit you and whoever you live with comfortably, and it can also entertain well. And it feels so much better to have a couch that's comfy than not comfy. So although I love really cute couches, I would say my priority is on comfort over aesthetic. So this couch luckily is beautiful and comfortable, and we got it from Interior Define, and we actually had it custom made. So it's huge, but it fits in this space because this space is actually pretty big for a couch. And we got the L, so it fits perfectly back there. And it's just really nice for lounging and hanging out. As far as decorating the couch, I love having different textures and materials and patterns in the pillows and the blankets and everything, just because I love mixing and matching things, whether it's fashion or decor. I love doing that with both. So for these pillows in particular, we kind of went with that antique, warm, homey vibe, and we got it's like a floral print on the smaller brown pillows. And then to sort of contrast that, but also complement it, we got a like lighter cream pillow with brown stripes, and I think they go really good together. And then I actually had two throw pillows that we weren't gonna use on our bed, and I was like, oh, I just wanna see how they look on the couch, and they ended up looking really good, and they just added another dimension of texture and pattern and everything. So I actually was not planning on using those with the couch, but I loved the way that they turned out. Having a little fringe on pillows or something is always something that I love. And then for a throw on the couch, I feel like that adds a really nice design element, and I do feel like it's worth investing in a throw that you think is really beautiful. So it might not be the comfiest throw, but I think in this situation, having it be really cute is worth it. So our throw is from Anthropologie, and it's not like a crazy amount. I think it was probably like $100 or something, which is expensive for a blanket, but it's not the comfiest. We still do lounge with it and use it, but we have a bin in our living room as well that has like more comfy blankets in it that aren't that aesthetic. So in this situation, I think it's worth having both if you are really focused on making your space look as aesthetic as possible while still being comfortable and functional. So yeah, that's kind of how we decorated the couch. And then on that wall, we think it's really fun to use light fixtures to sort of dress up any room. And in a living room, I think it's a really good opportunity to do that. So it worked in this space to have two because it was just like an even wall that we could space them out and they could be like very complementary to each other. So statement lighting, I think, does so much for a room. So these lamps, I guess I'll call them ceiling lamps. I don't know, wait, hanging lamps? I guess that's what you probably call them. I feel like hanging lamps are the perfect accent lighting for an office, a bedroom, a living room, anywhere you can fit them, because they really just transform a room, in my opinion. And these macrame boho vibes ones that we have are actually old from World Market, and I don't think they make them anymore. So I'll try to find something similar for you guys. But anything along that vibe, even if it's not boho or anything, I just think the hanging element makes such a difference. So we love that. And then in between those, we have a simple but large piece of artwork, and then we framed it in a vintage frame that is actually really cool. We got it at the Melrose Trading Post, and I think that ties in the whole element of the antique and homey vibe. And then as you can see, the picture has a positive saying on it because we love putting positive words and affirmations and everything in our home. I think that affects the energy in your home and just with you personally. So I love having a little element of that. And as far as like the storage goes in the living room, as I mentioned, it's nice to have a basket or something that is full of blankets that you actually like cuddling with but might not be design appropriate. So our blanket basket right now is actually not that cute, and it's overflowing, which is not ideal. I think it's best if you can have a lid on it and no one really knows what's in there. We don't have that going on right now, but that is the goal. And then we also have two floor cushions in our living room because we don't have a kitchen table. We don't have a dining setup here. So we actually eat dinner at our coffee table mostly, which is, I mean, it's fine with us. We've been doing it for years. We did it at our last place as well. But the floor cushions is just a nice way to make it a little more official that it's dining area down there. And then we kind of just store them away. We got those ones at Urban Outfitters, and they're really comfy. For a rug in the living room, I wanted to go with something pretty neutral and a little bit warm toned to just help with the space since it is cool toned. And I feel like you don't have to invest in rugs. There's some really good inexpensive rugs and they look beautiful and the quality is just fine. So I feel like that's one thing that you can get away with. Just study the pictures really, really well on the internet and like zoom in and see what the texture and everything looks like. Try to get one that the pile height is not super, super thin because that will look pretty bad, but there's so many affordable ones. So we did not spend that much on our rug. By all means, I think it's great if you do invest in a rug and you have a really nice rug, but I don't think it's necessary. I do like sort of a busy design on my rugs, if that makes sense. So I don't love plain rugs that much unless they have a really fun texture, like a shaggy texture. I like when they have like an intricate, busy design, but that is still pretty neutral, even if it has colors in it. If it's kind of muted and everything, I really prefer that for pretty much all the rugs in my space. So that's like a tip that I would give. And then for our media console, it's actually a buffet from Anthropologie, and it was totally an investment piece, but we are really happy with it because we feel like you can use it in so many different ways. So as you see here, we used it as a media console, and the reason that we really wanted that one is because we put our TV really high and we needed a console that complemented that, and it was so hard to find one. This was the only one that was tall enough really and that fit the design that we liked. So I think it was worth investing in. You can also use it as a buffet. You could put it in an office or even a bedroom probably. So I'm happy with it, but there's also some really affordable options like IKEA, Urban Outfitters, all that stuff. If you did want something that was less specific, you could probably find it without splurging. For decorating our coffee table and our media console, I like to style them because I feel like it just ties into the room and I just like accessorizing in any way that I can in my house. So for the media console, I did the two corners. Since the TV is in the middle, I felt that nothing needed to be on the middle. And for the corners, I love using books and trays. So one side we have a stack of books, the other side we have a tray. And then on those books or trays, I like to put little decorative pieces of art and knickknacks, candles, anything like that. The cute like old school jar of matches is a really nice touch. I love like sculpture type things. So I have this cute little female form sculpture. It's actually an incense holder from this amazing artist. Her name is Maya, and I'll link everything for you guys, of course, but I just love that little piece because I feel like it's really special, just made by a small artist. We love putting a nice candle up there as well because it kind of just lights up the whole room. It makes it smell good. It's totally worth all the ambiance that it creates. But if you don't want to invest in a candle either, any cute little candle, like Target has a bunch of cute aesthetic candles. They're not that expensive. I would put something like that up there. And then little candle accessories, like if you have scissors, the matches, anything like that, I think is really cute accessory for up there as well. And then just like some little vintage knickknacks. We got that vintage mirror from the Melrose Trading Post as well. And a nice vase or something is a good accessory. And then for the coffee table, I like to do the same thing and accessorize it. So on the lower shelf, I've pretty much just used stacks of books, and three or so is usually a good option. Since it didn't fill out the space enough, I did two sets of three on ours, and it's nice to have them be gradual in size from biggest on the bottom to smallest on the top. And then on the top of the coffee table, I love a tray. So since our coffee table is square, I thought it would be nice to offset it with a round tray. And then in that tray, again, I kind of just like to style it a bit. So a cute little vase. We actually made that vase from a tequila bottle and Clayton spray painted it. And then we just put some mini like pampas grass in there. And then we have some aesthetic little marble coasters. So I feel like just styling out those little corners and styling out the coffee table actually adds a lot to the room. It's just little details and accessories, but it kind of ties everything together instead of just leaving it blank. But if you're into like a very minimalistic thing, then that's cool too. Okay, and then the last thing that I'm gonna show you guys in this area is our bar cart. So depending on the way your house is laid out, I feel like a living room is a good space for a bar cart. We actually got ours from World Market, and I love that it has gold and mirror because it kind of goes with everything else. We have a lot of gold accessories, and then the mirrored effect just makes it seem brighter and opens things up, and it makes it seem very chic and classy. And then for styling that, I like to put like pretty glassware, decanters, anything like that, and then pretty-ish alcohol bottles. A nice variety and mix of colors and sizes and texture and everything I think is really nice for the alcohol mixture. You don't have to put any alcohol in your bar cart, and I think you can still style it really well. Just use little picture frames, candles, plants. Ours is not in any like natural sunlight, so I have a fake plant in ours. Vases, just little like knickknacks and stuff. I have some little statue type things that I think are actually bookends, and that's a really easy trick that you can just pick those up from TJ Maxx or Ross or anywhere like that and put them in the bar cart, and they're really nice little chic elements. I also get a lot of those cute vintage inspired glassware from TJ Maxx. Obviously, if you have the real deal and real vintage pieces, that's even better. But those are really inexpensive and they're really easy to pick up if you can't find the vintage ones. That's pretty much it. Just some simple artwork. I love putting like frames on the bar cart. I feel like it makes it seem just more decorative, and it's just fun. It's really easy to do as well, and layer the frame, so big ones in the back and small ones in the front. That is it for this first video on the design process and all the details and everything in our current decor situation. So I hope you guys like this video. If there's anything that I missed or anything that you have a specific question on, I'm happy to answer in the comments. And as always, I love chatting with you guys down there. I love your video suggestions. If you drop them in a comment, I will add them to my list and try to get to them all. And I'm excited to keep sharing these videos with you guys and showing you how we did this space, and then also sharing our future spaces and how we design them as well. So hope you guys like this, and I'll see you next time.